I will tell any parent, anyone who's in charge of children, anyone who is their guardian, know what is happening with them, know where they are, know who they're talking to on their phone. If you are, you're the parent, you pick up that phone, you need to look through it daily. I did that with my kids. I have 7 kids. I didn't want anything to happen. And even then, I had one daughter who was communicating with somebody that was a danger. And I wrote the book, you know. So you have to take your kid's phone, you got to look through their phone, look through the apps that they're on, make sure they're not communicating with somebody who is a predator, somebody who's dangerous, somebody that they don't even know who they're talking to. Also, you got to be on their Facebook, you got to be on their Twitter, you've got to know who they're talking with. Show up at their school, show up at where they're supposed to be having maybe music lessons, or if they're supposed to be in sports, or if they said they're babysitting, or they said that they're at a friend's house. Just every so often show up and make sure that they are where they are supposed to be. Be aware of who they're hanging out with. Make sure that when they come home from school, they're not just out on their own. Maybe they go to a neighbor's to do their homework or what have you. But, you know, our children, it's not our children's fault. Our children are young and they are trusting and they're innocent, but they are children. And so we're literally having to protect them from predators who are smart and who know how to find their weaknesses and who know how to groom and get to them. So we have to be the adults in the situation. Mm. We have to protect our young ones.
And you obviously write from a Christian worldview perspective.
Yes.
Talk about the role of the church in combating modern day human trafficking.
Yes. The church can particularly take a look at one out of every 4 homes is led by a single parent. That single parent generally is working very, very hard to keep a roof over their head and to keep food on the table. And so a lot of times they have less opportunity to keep an eye on where their children are at all times. But the church can pitch in. The church can help to say, you know, I'll keep an eye on, I'll stop by once in a while, I'll provide that, we'll go pick them up from school or we'll drop them off. Anything that you can do that you're helping that mom take care of her kids, anything that you can do that you can help that mother to be able to do what she's doing so that our kids stay safe. The churches can also make sure that you're checking the people that are working with the children, the youth pastors and the teachers and the coaches and that sort of stuff. But come alongside children and anybody that looks like they're just not fitting in. Find friends to come alongside them. Make sure that they have a good peer group. Invite them in. Get to know them. But we don't want anybody left behind. We don't want anybody left out on the fringes, because those are the ones that are being picked off.
Well, this is obviously a big issue. I know the statistic that many people cite is 27 million people being trafficked worldwide.
300,000 U.S. children every year. That's just our children.
And it is turned modern day slavery. And a point that you make, and I think it's a very good one, it's a great ending point for us today in our conversation, is that as we look at the history of the U.S., we can actually look at how this nation ended slavery.
Yes.
with respect to people owning other people of a different race. So we've seen that in our country, and we've seen it brought to an end. Now, here's another form of slavery. The possibility is there to end it, but it takes a lot of action and people banding together.
It is the ultimate epitome of bullying, and we stopped it once before, and we can stop it again. And there's no country on the planet that has slavery as something that's legal, and yet we have more slaves today than we ever have in history. We need to stand up and stop this.
So what are the answers that the legal system is offering?
It used to be that there was nothing illegal about being a John, about somebody who was utilizing these girls. We didn't have anything on the books about being a trafficker either, because it was so outside of our comprehension.
Right,
we didn't think we needed rules for it. There have been some states that have been very fast to step up and make legislation that says this is illegal, so that when the police do a bust, we can put these people behind bars. Some states are still very slow. They haven't caught up yet. So check your legislation in your area. But, you know, even if it's legal or not legal, push it so that it will be illegal to do this. But then at the same time, keep an eye on the children around you and make them as safe as you can.